Hi, this is 8 Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to tell you about how AdMob disabled my ads. Okay, so what I'm going to talk about today, I'm a little bit embarrassed about, but hopefully you'll bear with me and not think bad of me here. So, and I was debating whether or not I was going to tell you about this at all, because I talk a lot about AdMob and, you know, ad revenue from AdMob and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, and we've been doing really, really well with AdMob. You know, our one app, our biggest app has been doing so well. And then this morning when I woke up, I had an email waiting from AdMob, which said this: Google AdMob ad serving has been disabled for your application. And of course, when I open, I see that subject, I say, please don't be ear spy. And then I open it up and it is. So now I wasn't so concerned about that. I mean, I was concerned about this because it's, like about 100 pounds a day that generates. But basically one of my interstitial ads was kind of showing up in the wrong place. So it was, what it was doing was taking too long to load, and it was sort of popping up in the middle of the screen, and it wasn't in the middle of the transitions the way that it should be. So basically what I did, and I had a similar one like a year ago. So same time last year, I had this kind of email. This is why I'm embarrassed, because it's not the first time it's come through. However, a few weeks ago, I was telling you I was at an AdMob event and I talked a lot of other developers who have, you know, huge apps, and they all had the same experience. They talk about getting this email and going through all this. So this was the same one with this one. And basically what was happening is when you serve an interstitial ad, sometimes it could take a while to load. So what you want to do is to preload it and then show it only if it's been preloaded. So when I got this email, I went through, I checked all the guidelines and everything like that, and you try to see, what it says there is that the layout is encouraging accidental clicks. So I went through and everything like that, and basically made some quick changes, preload the ad, and then only show the ad when you're going from one page to another within the app. So it took me about 3 hours to make the changes and put that through, and it actually wasn't that bad. When it happened last year, I was devastated, I was terrified, I was like, what am I going to do with all this ad revenue? And this time, it was just, go through and, click, make some changes, submit it, appeal it, saying, hey, this is what I've done, this is my app, I'm sorry, I didn't mean for this to happen. Right now it's set up so that it's preloading, and it's only going to show if the ad has been preloaded. So if they're, they have a slow internet connection, and they go from one page to another, and that ad isn't loaded, it's not going to show anything, right? So already I've gotten the follow-up email here, I submitted it a couple hours ago, and, regarding the your appeal, it's been resolved already. So we're talking about 14 hours from going down, being removed, to being put back. So the AdMob team is actually very, very responsive here. So if this kind of thing happens to you, don't freak out. And I know from speaking to other developers, this kind of thing just happens from time to time. Or you may not follow, you may not know the guidelines as well as you should and stuff like that. Or you might think that everything's working great because you have a really fast internet connection. And other people, you're not thinking about what's going to be like on a slow connection. So now there's one really good page here. Well, actually, there's lots of really good pages on the AdMob support. But there's one that was showed to us like in PowerPoint a few weeks ago, like at this AdMob event. And it's really good. If you have a look at, if you go to AdMob help and you look at this disallowed interstitial implementations, it will tell you, how the interstitials should be implemented. Now, when I first started doing apps, people were giving me advice. People who didn't do apps were giving me advice saying, oh, what you should do is you should have the ad jump around the screen, and then that would force them to pay, or, all this kind of stuff, which is, which is illegal. Nobody wants that to happen. I mean, especially if, I always say that once you start taking out ads, you start to appreciate more about ad placements, and it's surprising how many people out there will try to spoof things and make things, easy to accidentally click on, which is not what you should be doing. And if you're doing something really sneaky, like have an auto generator that automatically clicks, that could get your account suspended, immediately. And I'm somebody who puts out ads all the time, and I'll pay, 20 pence a click or a pound a click or whatever like that. So, you know, for me, you know, I want those ads to be taken seriously and you know, not accidentally clicked because of a slow, you know, interstitial ad. But this page here, going back to this page, it's got like a lot of really good diagrams about how to use interstitial ads and how not to use them. So you see here, here you got this one here, say, you know, user clicks on the home page. You can't show an interstitial ad before you even show like the loading screen. However, and you don't want to do like when you show the interstitial ad on the exit either, you know, because there's no, you know, let your user exit the application. But what you can do is you can say, you know, show a loading screen and then get that interstitial ad ready, show the interstitial ad, and then go straight to your main screen. And there's lots of examples here, lots of things that you may not have actually been aware of, like you don't want to have like an interstitial ad between every single bit of navigation, but you might want to have it through a few of them. And it has to be like at a good juncture. So when the user clicks on something, say like they finish a level in a game, or they've you know, they're going from one screen to another, maybe you want to show that interstitial ad there. You don't want to show too many, because then it's, well, it's going to, you know, it's going to irritate your users, and it's also going to be, it also violates the policy too. But you might want to show, you know, one every few minutes, and don't do like mine was doing up until this morning, which was having that slow load time and it just sort of pops up in the middle because it's not at that you know, that break within the application, within the flow of the application. So anyway, this is just something to be made aware of. I mean, if you're having this kind of problem with the ads, please let me know in the comments if you've had this kind of problem in the past. I know a lot of people had trouble with, you know, when they tell me they've had their AdMob account suspended. And I said, oh, really, what happened? And I'm concerned. They said, oh, I was clicking on my own ads within the apps. And I think, well, yeah, you don't want to be doing that, right? That's why you should set up test devices and you put all that stuff in your code. You know, what I always tell people when they're really curious about how RPM works and how you get paid for ads, one really good way to find out is actually opening, you know, taking out ads for yourself, because then you can see all the different options that the publishers or the advertisers actually go through, and they can say, oh, I'm going to do it per click or per install or per number of impressions, all that kind of stuff. And it's when you start to do that, you start to see the importance of, you know, of the proper layout, and you start to see, you know, how you can actually generate more revenue by making these things more findable for things. So that's it for this week. Just a little bit of a mea culpa. For the second time, I've had my ads stopped, but within 14 hours had them resumed. So I don't feel so bad about it, but, you know, we all make mistakes. And that's it for this week. Oh, and I'll also let you know how it affects my RPM. I mean, you know, the irony is, just like a week ago, I did a video talking about the RPM I get. And now I'm gonna, you know, now this might change it because we've maybe people were accidentally clicking. I hope that wasn't the case, but I'll let you know in the coming weeks how that affects it. I suspect it's gonna stay the same because I don't think it's gonna be the case for everybody. But just in case it goes down, you know, we'll know that was the case, and hopefully not. So that's it for this week. Oh, and if you liked the video, you know, click on like. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, you know, go right ahead. We do this every Friday, even when something bad happens. You know, if you're on Snapchat, go ahead and follow us at this snap code here. And, you know, this is where you find out first about stuff like this. You know, when I wake up in the morning, I go, oh man, you know, the ups and downs, and, you know, I basically talk about AdMob revenue all the time. So that's it for this week. I hope it's been useful. I'll talk to you next week.